here just in time to see Harry drink one of Mr. Hooper's super duper ice cream sodas. Well, Harry, how do you like the ice cream soda?
Oh, Mr. Hooper, that's really fine. That's really good, yeah.
He likes it.
Good.
Yeah, good.
But, you know, it looks good, but why are you drinking it so slow, you know?
Slow?
Yes, you're drinking it slowly.
What slowly?
Oh, come on, Harry. You know the difference between fast and slow.
Fast? Slow?
Yeah.
I don't know.
He doesn't know.
You don't? Huh. Now, Ferris, why don't you tell him the difference between fast and slow?
Sure, I will. Well, let's see. Slow was the way you were drinking the chocolate soda. You were drinking it, but only a little bit at a time.
Oh, so that's slow.
Yeah.
Yeah, but what's fast?
Oh, well, let's see. Something fast. Oh, you want to see something fast?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Oh, okay, here we go. There, that was fast.
Yeah, that was fast.
Yeah.
And you better be fast, too, because I'm going to get you.
Oh, I think I hear my mother calling me. Bye. Oh.
You want to have some fun?
Sure.
Look, see those kids over there in the playground? I'll show you how things look when they go slow and fast.
Okay.
Go fast! Hey, wow! Wanna see the slow?
Sure.
Okay, everybody, go slow!
Suppose we could make him go slow and fast.
Let's try it.
Go fast, Big Bird!
Now go slow, Big Bird. Go slow.
Hey, there's nobody in it. Let's get in it and see if we can make it go fast.
Go, go faster!
Faster!
Hey! Hey, it's going too fast! Too fast! Slow it down!
Slow. Fast. Slow.
All right, places, please. Places, please, for the Little Miss Muffet number. Little Miss Muffet?
Hello, Lance.
Yes, how are you, sweetheart?
Where shall I stand?
Sit down right there on your Muffet.
Oh, wait.
Your Tuffet there.
Oh, yes,
okay.
I'm Miss Muffet. That's a
spider. Where's the spider?
Oh, here I am. Hope I'm not late.
Okay. No. You don't have your costume on.
He has no costume,
Lance. Go out and get on your spider costume.
Yes.
Go on. Okay, here we go. Little Miss Muffet.
Where's my
music?
Where's my Tuffet? Oh, there it is.
Okay. Little Miss Muffet sat on a Tuffet, eating her curds and whey. Along came a spider. Along came a spider.
Oh, no, wait a minute. That's not the spider outfit. That looks like a rabbit outfit to me.
Oh.
You see, a rabbit A rabbit has these two long ears like that. Oh. And a spider doesn't have long ears. And a rabbit has this nose here and whiskers. Now, a spider does not have nose and whiskers or those teeth. Now go get in your spider outfit, please.
All right. Sorry about that, sweetheart. We'll do it again. We'll just start again from the top, everyone. All right?
I can't work like this, Lance.
Don't worry about it. All right, Little Miss Muffet. Music!
All right.
Little Miss Muffet sat on a tuffet, eating her curds and whey. Along came a spider, and... Oh, no.
Hold it. Cut. Hold it.
Why?
Don't you understand
Why?
What a spider looks like?
Why?
That looks like a duck, not
huh?
a spider.
Oh.
Yes, a duck has these wings here, you see? You have wings on, and over here, too. That's not... A spider doesn't have wings.
Oh, I'm sorry.
A duck has this beak here, but a spider does not have a beak.
I didn't know.
Just go get a new spider outfit, please. Lance, where are you?
All right.
Oh,
I'm
Lance.
Sorry about that, sweetheart.
What
we'll just take it again, all right?
All right.
Do the whole thing over. Little Miss Muffet. Music!
Like something's wrong with my tuffet, too.
Little Miss Muffet sat on a tuffet, eating her curds and whey. Along came a spider and oh, no.
Oh, now wait. This is the last straw. I told you, the spider outfit, that looks like the fish outfit. You see, a fish has these fins here. See the fins here?
Uh-huh.
That's not a spider outfit. And the tail?
Uh-huh.
A spider does not have a tail.
Uh-huh.
And these eyes are fish eyes. All right, I'll have to do it for you, okay?
Uh-huh.
Now, what the thing is, see here? Here's one spider eye, right?
Yeah.
And here's another spider eye right there.
Uh-huh.
All right, now I'll get your spider hairy legs on.
Okay.
Now, a spider has eight hairy legs. I'll get one. Does that tickle?
It tickles.
All right, well, let's do it. One, two, three. There's four legs. Five, six, seven. There's eight legs. Now you look like a spider, you see?
Oh.
Lance, I think we're ready.
Okay, we're finally ready.
Yes,
all right,
I think
we now
so.
Have a spider.
Yes, we have a nice spider. Spider?
And frightened Miss Muffet away.
Hi-ho, everybody. It's the ever-popular Letter on the Street interview show. Here's a likely-looking letter. Your name?
N.
How are you?
Nice.
Do you mind if I ask you some questions?
No.
Where are you from?
North.
Ever been on TV before?
Never.
You like it?
Nifty.
Would you like to say a few words?
Not, nibble, new, night, now.
Thank you.
Nag, neat, nine, near, numb.
Thank you very
Nose,
much.
Nose, nickel, yep. number.
We're a little late,
not
folks,
nick,
so
nap.
Bye-bye.
Nerve, new, net.
26 letters in the alphabet, and I gotta get in.
Hi there. Oh, my feet are just killing me. Ooh, they hurt. I'm not tired. I'm not the least bit tired. It's my feet. Well, it's my lunch hour, so I'll just sit down a minute and take the load off my feet. Oh, maybe I'll just slip off my shoes for just a minute, you know? Oh, that's terrific. Oh. Oh, what a relief. Well, no wonder my feet hurt. I really goofed this morning when I got up and got dressed. I put on my old beat-up shoes, you know, that need to go to the shoemaker. They need new soles. You can see how much I walk each day on my job. I've worn a hole in the bottom of each shoe. Oh, well, it's my lunch hour. And I feel so good. I'll just put my shoes here and just rest my feet. Oh, it's delicious. Oh, feels so good. Oh.
In an old and far off place, there was a lowercase n. Lonely and cold, she would stare off into space, and it was known that she would cry now and then. Lowercase n, standing on a hill. The wind is very still for the lowercase n. Then one day a rocket ship came racing from started coming outside. A lowercase n.
She's not lonely anymore.
They are standing on the hill.
There are two that stand for sure.
The wind is very still for the lowercase n.
Time for my daily trash hunt. Every day I like to wander down the street and check it out for possible additions to my trash collection. Oh, what's this? Oh, a little tin can. Kind of rusty. Somebody's left it right here on the sidewalk. Doesn't look like they want it. It's really beautiful. Yeah, I think I'll just pick it up and that will look very nice on my coffee table. Let's see what else there might be around. Maybe I'll go this way and take a look. Dun, dun, dun. Oh, hey, what are these? Look at these beat up old shoes somebody's thrown away. Hey, they got neat holes and they're all kind of worn looking and crummy. You know what they'd be perfect for? I just got some prickly cactus plants and I could plant them in these old shoes. That would look great. Oh, yeah. Look at these shoes. This is my lucky day. Oh, yeah. Great, great trashy day. Taking the trash away. Dun, dun, dun.
Circle. 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 Two circles. Circle.
Hello, I'm Alice Braithwaite Goody Shoes. Look what I brought you today. The letter G. The first letter in the word good. That's what I am in school. And good at dinner and good...
Ooh.
Ooh.
Gee, that was good.
Oh, hi. You know what I'm carrying in this box? Well, it's a nice big cream pie, and I'm taking it to Maria's house. So I gotta carry it really careful. Uh-oh. Oh, look at that. Molly's asleep. Gosh, and here I am talking loud. I might wake her up. Poor mail lady, she's probably tired, and that's why she needs a nap.
So I better be quiet. I better tippy-toe, too.
Oh, hi, Big Bird!
Shh, you're asleep. You're awake?
Yes, I'm awake, Big Bird. I was asleep, but I just awoke. And... Hey, Big Bird, I gotta get up anyway. I gotta go back to work.
Well, I hope you had a nice nap.
I did, that I did. Oh, I forgot my feet.
You didn't wear your feet?
No, I forgot them. I better go back and get my shoes.
How could you forget your feet? They're attached to your legs.
I put my shoes right here.
Oh, you mean your shoes.
I put them right here, Big Bird. Now, where could they be?
Gee, I don't know.
Well, I don't understand. I caught you, Big Bird. Huh? You were playing a joke on me.
I am?
Yes. You saw me sleeping there, so you thought you'd play a joke, and you took the shoes and you put them in the box and you were going to tiptoe out.
Oh, but Molly.
Well, listen, it's enough now. I really have to get back to work. Just let me have what's in the box and I'll slip it on and get back to work.
You're going
to
put what's in this box on your feet?
Oh, I certainly am.
But Molly, I don't think you...
Oh, yes, I've got to. I just got to...
I don't think you should slip it on your feet.
I got to slip it on my... No! It's a pie!
Yeah, it won't taste so good if you put your feet in it.
Big Bird, I almost put my foot in a pie.
I know. Why did you want my pie anyway?
Big Bird, if this pie was in the box, then where are my shoes?
Gosh, Molly, I haven't seen them. Don't look at me.
Well, I don't understand. Why were you sneaking around then and tiptoeing around if you didn't have my shoes?
Well, I just saw you asleep and I didn't want to wake you up.
My shoes. I can't deliver my mail without my shoes.
Well,
I need
maybe
a pair
I can
of
help
shoes.
You find them.
Oh, do you now, think you could find me a pair of shoes just to get home?
Oh, sure. Now you just sit down and rest. I'll be right back with a pair of shoes.
Thank you, Big Bird. You are a dear pal.
You're welcome, Molly.
Oh, hurry.
I can find a pair of shoes somewhere.
Oh, dear. I put the shoes right here.
What was that?
It is just the door creaking, that is all.
Everybody says that this old place is haunted.
Oh, no. It is just a deserted house, and no one lives here, that is all.
What was that?
There is nothing to be frightened of. It is just this old grandfather clock chiming.
Oh, I'm still kind of scared. Listen to that. It's somebody's moaning.
No, Walter, there is nothing to be frightened of. It is just the sound of the wind.
Help! What was that?
It is just thunder and lightning. There is nothing to be frightened of. Relax.
Well, I guess you're right.
Sure.
Oh, look at that. A cute little white mousie.
Eek! A mouse! A mouse! Oh, that is something to be frightened of. Eek!
Don't be scared, little mousie.
I gotta deliver my mail and I can't find my shoes. Some joker took my shoes. Big Bird said he'd try to find me some. I hope he comes soon.
Molly!
Yeah?
Molly, I found some shoes for you.
Oh, thank you, Big Bird. Bless your heart. Let me have them.
Sure, here they are.
Oh, Big Bird, where did you get these shoes?
Mrs. Tomaselli. I told her I need a pair of shoes and these belong to her baby. But you know, he's grown so fast. He can't wear them.
Big Bird, would you tell me, did you tell Mrs. Tomasino the shoes were for me?
No, I just said I needed a pair of shoes.
Well, I'm afraid these won't do, Big Bird. There's something wrong with them.
Why? What's wrong? Are they the wrong color?
No, Big Bird. Here, let me put them by my feet and maybe you can tell me what's wrong.
I think I see what's wrong.
Your feet are too big.
That's right!
Could you maybe get smaller feet, Molly?
Smaller feet? No, Big Bird. I don't think I can do that. But maybe you could get a larger shoe. What do you think?
Hey, maybe I could find a bigger pair of shoes.
I can take these back to Mrs. Tomaselli.
All right.
Okay, now you stay here, and I'll get you a bigger pair of shoes.
All right, I'll stay here. Where am I going to go?
Which come first, the chicken or the egg? How could something so fat and furry come from something so smooth and pearly? Which come first, the chicken or the egg? Which come first, the feather or the shell? Which come first, the feather or the shell? When you see one egg or t'other, do you ever think about its mother? Oh, which come first, the feather or the shell? Now, eggs are awful pretty, lying on a plate, or sitting here in a cotton eating spray. And looking inside a box of eggs might make you feel so great, but do you ever wonder where they was before there was inside that crate? Which come first, the chicken or the egg? Oh, which come first, the chicken or the egg? If you wanted to begin again, would you start with an omelet or a hen? Oh, which come first, the chicken or the egg? The chicken or the egg?
Oh, dear, I feel so silly without my shoes. I hope Big Bird comes with some shoes that fit.
Oh, Molly, Molly, I got some at last.
Oh, thank you, Big Bird.
You're welcome. Here they are.
What are these?
Oh, well, these are my rain boots.
Rain boots?
Mm-hmm.
Big Bird, how can I wear your rain boots?
Oh, easy. It doesn't matter because it's not raining. I don't need them.
Oh, isn't that, Big Bird? I mean, the size. Look at them.
You mean they aren't big enough for you?
Oh, no. The thing is, I think they're so big I won't be able to keep them on my feet.
I see. Don't have any shoes to wear, and the first pair I bring are too little, and now these are too big.
Oh.
I can't seem to help anybody.
Oh.
It's all right, Molly.
No, Big
I'm
Bird.
I'm just no good, that's all.
Oh, Big Bird, that's you're just true, wonderful, true. And I can't tell you how grateful I am, and I love you for it, and I'll wear them.
You are?
Oh, yes, Big Bird.
You mean you're going to wear them?
Oh, yes, I'm going to put on your big rain boots.
You mean I've really helped you?
You really have. Oh, nobody's going to believe this.
Oh, Molly, they look wonderful on you.
Well, fine.
All the birds are just going to be so envious.
Yes, if I were a bird, I would be too. Wait, now let me get my mail bag.
Gosh, they look really fine.
Thank you very much.
You're very welcome, Molly. Have a good day.
Thank you. You, Mr. Hooper.
Yes, hi, Molly.
Hi, got your mail.
Got my mail?
Yeah. Here you go, Mr. Hooper. Yeah.
Rectangle.
just count monkeys. That's one monkey. Two monkeys. I believe that's three monkeys. Make that four monkeys. That's five monkeys. And when you have five monkeys, you have a lot of monkey business. Stop that monkey business. Come on, you monkeys.
Oscar, I got some mail for you.
Hi, Molly. How are you?
I feel terrible.
Oh, that's great. Really? You feel terrible? What's the matter?
Oh, well, I was just taking a nap on my lunch hour, and some joker went off with my shoes, and Big Bird was such a dear. He gave me his rain boots, and they're a little big, and I feel just absolutely ridiculous.
Hey, look at those. Hey, you do look ridiculous. Molly, that really looks funny.
What makes you in such a grand mood today, Oscar?
Oh, well, I went on my trash hunt today, you know, and I found some really great stuff
this
morning.
That's nice.
What a stuff some people throw away. Uh-huh. Where do you see it?
Oh, I don't have time, Oscar. I'm way behind schedule on my route. I've got to go now.
Well, wait a minute, Molly. I found two great planters for my new prickly cactus plants.
Well, I've really got to be on
my
way.
Well, they were old and beat up, and they had holes in the bottom, but I put my cactus plants in them, and they look just great.
Uh-huh.
Don't you want to see them?
Oh, well, if it'll take just a minute.
It'll only take a second.
Oh,
come on, Alcum.
Hurry.
Yeah, I'm hurrying.
All right.
I really want you to see them.
Uh-huh.
You're really going to love these. Just a second. Ouch. Little prickly here. Mm-hmm. Ah! Oh, watch it.
Well, I'll wait one more.
There we are.
Uh-huh. Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
Huh?
That's lovely.
Yes.
That's...
Yeah, huh?
My shoes!
Your shoes?
Yes, they're
mine. What do you mean, your shoes? These old beat-up things with the holes in the bottom?
Yes, where'd you find them?
Well, on the sidewalk over there. I thought that somebody threw them off.
Well, no. I know they're old and worn out, and they have to go to the shoemaker, but they're mine, and I need them, and I'm keeping them.
You mean I can't keep them, but I love them?
No, I'm sorry. I need them.
Well,
I'll tell you what I'll do,
right.
Oscar. I'll clean them up, take out the cactus, go back to work, and then I'll bring back the cactus plant after I finish my route, all right? Bye.
Hey, Molly.
Yes.
Oh, there you are. I've been looking all over for you.
Uh-huh.
We haven't gotten our mail yet down this end of the block.
Oh, well, just a minute.
It's all kind of late.
Just wait one minute, will you? Please, I'll get my shoe on.
Oh.
Ah!
Okay, all you cats and kitties, it's time for a little addition. Can you dig it? Here we go. Now, adding is putting together. Adding is just what you do. When you have one cookie and I have one cookie, together they add up to two. One cookie and one cookie make two cookies. One and one is two. That's two. Woo! Yeah, out of sight. Mm-hmm. Adding is putting together. Mm-hmm. And I'm sure you will agree. If you have two cookies and add one more cookie, the answer will always be three. Two cookies and one cookie make three cookies. Two and one is three. Oh! together. Adding is making it more. Just take those three cookies, add one more cookie. This time the answer is four. Three cookies and one cookie make four cookies. Three and one is four.
Hey, cookies, hey, what you doing?
Singing about addition.
Why you not sing about subtraction?
Subtraction?
Yeah, sure, I show you. Subtracting is taking away from... Oh, subtracting is my kind of fun. Now listen, see, when you have four cookies and I see four cookies, I subtract them and leave you with none. See, because four cookies minus four cookies is no cookies. And now our song is done. And so are the cookies. Oh, nom, 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 nom,
nom, nom, nom, nom, nom, nom. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Out of sight.
Yeah.
Hola, este es Guillermo, mi famoso cuervo que habla.
Hola, este es Eugenio, mi famoso hombre que habla.
Te vamos a hablar de la letra N, ¿verdad, Guillermo?
¿Tienes unos gusanos?
Guillermo, no nos gusta ese ruido.
A mí tampoco me gusta.
¿Sabes alguna palabra que comience con N?
No.
Te lo preguntaré así. ¿Qué empieza con la letra N?
Nada.
¿Quién me puede decir qué empieza con la letra N?
Nadie.
Guillermo, ¿cuándo me vas a decir qué empieza con la letra N?
Nunca.
¡Oye, cabeza hueca!
Disculpe, señor. Guillermo le dio bien la respuesta cada vez. Dijo no, nada, nadie, nunca. Y cada una de esas palabras comienza con la letra N.
¡Claro!
Tiene razón. Perdóname, Guillermo. Eres el pájaro más listo de todo el mundo.
¡Claro, claro! Y tengo las plumas más bonitas también.
Talking about fast and slow. Let's see. How slow we can count these rubber duckies. Huh?
How slowly, right?
Yes.
All right.
And we'll also see how many there are, right?
Everybody together?
All right, you ready?
Okay.
Follow.
One. Two. Three. Four.
Now we have seven duckies, right? Rubber duckies. Now let's see how fast we can go. You ready? Go!
Well, you're right.
Hey, that's pretty fast. Hey, you know what? I've been hanging around with Luis and Rafael, and I think I can count them very slowly, maybe in Spanish, but you have to listen, okay?
All right.
In Spanish?
Yeah.
Wow.
You check me to see if I'm right.
All right.
Uno.
Uno.
Dos. Tres.
Right.
Tres. Cuatro.
Right.
Cuatro.
Cinco. Right.
Cinco. Seis.
Right.
Siete. Siete. Is that right?
Oh, that's
right.
Very cool.
I bet you can count them a lot faster than that in Spanish, right?
Right.
Let me hear how fast you can count them in Spanish, okay? I'll listen. See. Watch this. All right.
Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete.
Woo!
Whoa.
Hey, you know, I think she counted faster in Spanish than you
maybe,
did in English.
Maybe. No, I can count much faster in English.
I think she can count faster in Spanish.
That's all right.
Let's see.
But I can count faster in English, not in Spanish.
Let's count up to seven as fast as we can, whatever language we want to count in, all right? You do it in Spanish, I'll do it in English. What are you going to do it in, Mr. Cooper?
Yiddish.
You're going to count Yiddish?
Yes.
Okay, and you're in English, right? Okay, on your mark, and you two, anybody that wants to count, count whatever language you want to. Ready? On your mark, get set, go!
Say it good.
Bueno.
Good.
Good.
Bert! Oh, Bert! Hey, Bert, listen. Listen, Bert, you got to come quick out into the kitchen, Bert, because something terrible's happened out in the kitchen. You got to come out
into
the kitchen, Bert,
slow
real
down,
quick,
Ernie.
Bert.
Ernie. No, wait. See, I can't understand a word you're saying. You're talking too fast. Just slow down.
Yes, Bert, but you got to come real quick out into the kitchen here, Bert, because...
No, Ernie. I still can't understand you. Just talk slow, real slow now, okay?
Okay.
Okay, now.
Bert, yeah. What? What I wanted to tell you is that the bread that you put in the toaster is burning, Bert.
My bread is burning? Yeah. Oh, Ernie, why didn't you tell me sooner? Oh, my bread. Oh, look at all that bread. It's all ruined. Ernie, my bread is ruined.
Wait a second, Bert. Bert, stop. What? You gotta talk slower. I can't understand you, Bert.
Okay. How many people are sitting on the steps of 123 Sesame Street? You don't see anybody? You just wait. There's one, Mr. Hooper. Oh, now there's two. And now there's three. Susan makes three. And there's Bob. Bob makes four. Four people sitting on the front steps. Oh, wait a second. Now there's five. Vanessa makes five people sitting on the front steps. And there's Gordon. Gordon makes six. Oh, and there's somebody else. Now there are seven people on the steps of 123 Sesame Street. Now what would happen if we mixed everybody up like this? Nobody leaves and nobody else comes in. Now let's see, okay, everybody's mixing up. Now wait, why does everybody wave? Good idea, great. Now we can count you. There's one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Still seven people on the steps. Now everybody mix up another time. Nobody leave and nobody else come in, okay? Just mix up. Good. Okay, now everybody keep mixing and we'll see how many people there are. Oh, they're mixing every which way. Now hold still so we'll count you again. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Now wait, let's subtract one from seven and we have six. Now we have six people on the steps. Now we subtract one from six and we get five. There are five people on the steps. How about that? Now five take away one leaves four people sitting on the steps. And four people take away one leaves three people on the steps of 123 Sesame Street. Now take away one more. There's two. One from three is two. Now take away one more. And there's one person on the front steps. Now take away one more person, and that leaves nobody. Nobody sitting on the steps of 123 Sesame Street.
Hey, listen, everybody! Hold on! The James twins are in town, and they're headed this way!
Oh, no.
Not the James twins. Oh, boy, that's double trouble.
They do everything together.
Yeah, and everything they do is mean.
Hey, listen, when they come in, we better give them anything they want.
Yeah,
anything.
Right.
See what they want.
Hey, go see.
Yeah.
You talk to them.
And remember, we give them anything.
Right.
Anything.
You go ahead.
Howdy, Mr. James Twins. You can have anything you want. The place is yours.
We want Muse.
Muse? Why, you got it.
Mew.
Ick. Ick, you don't like our Muse?
Oh, no.
They don't like our Muse.
Who did it wrong? Hey, what's going on?
We want Muse.
Mew.
Ick. Ick. Oh, no. Still no good?
No good.
Oh, what are we gonna do?
We want Muse.
Ick.
Muse.
Ick.
Muse.
Ick. That's it. They don't want Muse. They want Muse. Ick. Music.
That's right.
Yeah, coming right up. Music, okay. Get over and play that thing, Shorty.
Okay, everybody, dance.
Right.
Ooh, yeah, let's
come on,
dance.
Fellas.
Okay, burn them. Okay, stop around here. Stop.
Hold. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 7. 7.
siete. Siete, siete. Siete. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, diez.
George, what is that sound you are making?
Hi, Grover. I'm making the sound of the next letter of the alphabet, the letter G. Yeah, my name begins with the letter G, and it makes that sound. George.
But my name begins with G, too, but it sounds like this. Grover. G, Grover.
No, G, George.
G garden.
No, no. G giant.
G gallop.
G giraffe.
No, no. I think this is right, Georgie. G golden.
And G gentle. Hey, Grover.
What? Georgie.
There are two G sounds.
I must agree. There is G good guy.
And G genius.
One sound for you and one sound for me. G Grover,
G George, G Grover,
G George, G George,
G.
Smells pretty good. Not so good. Well, here are some things that belong together. Here are some things that are kind of the same. Here are some things that belong together. And now it's time to play our game. Okay, now take a good look at these two things over here, okay? 'Cause one of these things goes with the others. See if you can guess which one. Well, guess which thing goes with the others, and guess before my song is done. Okay, now let's take a close look at all of the things we have here. Here we have a cat, right? Here a bunny rabbit, and here that skunk. Now over here we have a squirrel, and a nice big pretty sunflower. Think you figured out which one of these things goes over there? Well, one of these things goes with the others. Do you think that this one might? Well, if you guess that this thing goes with the others, then you're absolutely right. Hey, how'd you do? Did you guess that the squirrel belonged over here with all of these other animals? Well, if you did, you were right, because these four are all animals, right? But this is a flower. This is a plant. Not an animal, a nice, big, pretty sunflower. So therefore, the animal or the squirrel is the one that belongs over there with all the rest, and the sunflower doesn't belong with those.
The story of Nancy the Nanny Goat is brought to you by the letter N. Nancy the Nanny Goat lived north of Nantucket. Nancy had a pet, a nice nightingale.
I am a nightingale.
Now, Nancy was a nincompoop because around her neck she wore a narrow napkin. One night in November at 9:09, she got a notion to visit a nutty nanny goat farm.
Numbskull, nitwit, nincompoop
were some of the nasty names the other nanny goats called her as she sat nibbling on her nails. The granny nanny goat noticed Nancy and said,
Nancy, don't be a ninny. Never nibble on your nails.
Nancy became nervous. She took off the narrow napkin and put on a nifty necklace. Instead of nibbling her nails, she started to notice noodles. Granny Nanny Goat noticed Nancy and said,
Nanny goats who nibble on their nails and notice noodles are nutty.
This story of Nancy the Nanny Goat was brought to you by the letter N.
Oh, isn't that nice? Gordon is reading a storybook. I wonder if it has pictures. He seems to be enjoying it, doesn't he? And there's Bob. He's making bubbles. And Gordon wants to play with the bubbles, but Bob won't give them to him. Bob said no again. Oh no, now Gordon has the bubbles and the book. And poor Bob. Bob has nothing to play with. Oh, very nice, Gordon. Now you each have something to play with. See how cooperation helps everybody?
Waiter, waiter, I'd like to order...
One moment. Yes, sir, I'm ready now. What can I do for you?
Yes, I'd like a bowl of chicken soup, please.
Very good choice. You've been here before, haven't you? I'll be right back. One bowl of chicken soup, Charlie!
That settles it. I don't know why I keep coming back to this place. This guy gives me a hard time every time I come in here. If it's not one thing, it's another.
Charlie. Okay, sir. Here we have your delicious chicken soup.
Yes. Waiter!
Yes, sir.
I can't eat this soup.
You can't eat this soup? Of course not. I can feel it. It is too cold. I will get you another bowl of soup. I'm sorry, sir. Hey, Charlie, how about a hot bowl this time, okay? Give the guy a break.
Well, that settles it. From now on, I'm bringing my lunch to work in a paper sack.
Okay, Charlie, I think you'll be happy this time. There you are, sir.
Now, I...
Have a good and hearty meal.
Yes, but... Waiter!
Oh, I bet that's too hot now. Okay, I'll blow on it for you.
The problem is, you forgot to bring...
Well, I forgot the salt, didn't I? Of course. The pepper.
No.
The crackers.
No.
Well, then tell me, why can't you eat the soup, sir?
Why don't you taste it?
All right, sir. The customer is always right. I shall taste it. Mm-hmm. Where's the spoon?
Aha!
Oh, I forgot the spoon. Oh!
You can't eat soup without a spoon.
I'm so sorry, sir.
Wow.
There's the spoon.
Now.
Next time, when you want the spoon, ask for one.
N is naughty. N is nice. N is nodding once or twice. N is nickel. N is noon. N is nibbling with a spoon. N is nest. N is nut. N is nose that has a cut. N is night. Now it's nine. N is nursing. And you're fine. N.
Well, I'm going to ask you a few questions, and I want to see if you really know what we're looking at, right? What is it? What is this a picture of?
A boy.
A boy? Yes. Yes. And a nurse, right? So where are we in? Or where are they in?
A scale.
A scale? Well, not really. They're in the doctor's office, right?
Right.
Huh? And what do you think this... She may look like a nurse, but she's a doctor, right? You agree with me?
A doctor.
She's a doctor.
That's a man's name.
A doctor is a woman's name too. And if you're a doctor, you can be a man doctor, you can be a woman doctor, and you're still called a doctor, right? All right. Now, what is this machine? Do you know? What is that machine called? That's a fluoroscope. That's what the machine is called. This doctor, this woman doctor, uses the machine to see what's inside the person who's standing behind the machine. Huh? And when the person moves behind the machine and the doctor puts the machine on, this is what we see. You see? The insides of the person behind the machine. Right?
Right.
And that is called a fluoroscope. Now we're seeing the bones of that particular person behind the machine. Do you know that there are some fish that are so thin, and the thin is so skin, that you can see inside the fish without a fluoroscope? You know that? Look at that. Look at that.
Oscar? Hey,
what?
I got the game to play. It's called Alphabet Game.
Well,
you want to play?
I don't want to play it.
I knew you'd want to play it. Okay, now, here, I'm going to start, okay? A is for apple.
B is for black.
C is for cute.
D is for disgusting.
E is for enjoy.
F is for frightful.
G is for glad and also for Grover.
H is for horrible.
I is for ice cream.
J is for junk.
K is for... kiss.
Well, L is for lousy.
And M is for marvelous. And N is for nice. N is for nice.
O is for Oscar.
O? P is for play.
Q is for quit.
R is for run.
S is for sickening.
T is for terrific.
U is for ugly.
V is for vanilla.
W is for worst.
X is for xylophone.
And Y is for yucky, and Z is for zero, and that's what saying the alphabet is with you, yucky and a great big zero!
I liked it.
One! Two! Three! Four! Five! Six! Seven! Eight! Nine! Ten! 11!
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters G and N, and by the number 7. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.